Browsers today come with a number of fantastic experimental features that are not yet ready for a public release, but are good enough for you as a developer to play around with them. And those features are usually hidden, but do you know how to enable them? This is exactly what I'll show you in this video, how to enable experimental web development features in Chrome, Firefox, and Safari. That way, you'll be able to test out the latest and greatest web APIs that browsers have to offer. Let's dive in. First up, we have Google Chrome, and in Chrome, you can find experimental features if you go into the address bar and enter chrome:// flags. And here, you're gonna see all experiments that are currently available in Chrome. If you scroll down, you're gonna see that there's a ton and ton of those experiments, but when it comes to web features, when it comes to CSS and JavaScript, mostly what you want to enable is experimental web platform features. I'll search for exactly that. Experimental web platform features. Basically, this activates all smaller experimental features, and those are features by Chrome's definition that take no more than 1 to 2 quarters of work, and this would probably include a lot of the CSS-related things that we talk about on this channel if they're not enabled by default in the browser. This is probably the flag that you want to enable if you want to play around with those features. The problem is that I haven't really been able to find exactly a list of features that this particular flag includes. So there's no single unified place where I could go and see, okay, if I enable this flag, I'm going to have experimental has support or whatever it is that currently is behind this flag. So once you enable this, you will need to restart the browser and then you'll be able to use those experimental features. And all other experimental features that are a bit bigger, those will be under their own flag. So for example, if you want to play around with the share API, you can search for share and you're going to see web share, which enables web share navigation share API. And then if you enable this flag, you'll be able to play around with it. So for smaller features, enable experimental web platform features flag. And for all the other bigger features, enable them exactly when you need them, if you need them. And you can enable experimental features exactly in the same way in all other browsers that are Chromium based. So in Microsoft Edge, for example, you would also open a flags page here, but instead of Chrome, you would say Edge:flags. This would then open exactly the same screen in Edge browser. And again, you would enable experimental web platforms features, or you would enable a specific feature that you want to see. Next, we have Firefox, and Firefox works very similarly. URL that you need to open is about config. When you open it, at least for the first time, you will have a warning. And if you accept the risk, because you will be enabling experimental features, and some of those features might not be stable or might cause your browser to crash, but that rarely happens from my experience, so proceed with caution, but do proceed. I'll click the button, and here you can search for the preference name. Firefox doesn't have a unified flag for minor features. You will have to enable every feature that you want to use, that you want to experiment with separately. So if you want to see which CSS features are available, you can search for CSS, for example, and then you'll see a number of layout CSS features that are available. Some of those are enabled, some of those are set to false, which means that they are not enabled. So if you want to play with any of those features, you will find them exactly here, and then you can enable them. Once you enable them, once you restart the browser, you'll be able to test out the latest and greatest what Firefox has to offer. You can also find a list of experimental features on MDM docs. You're going to find them all here on this page, experimental features in Firefox. And if you scroll down, you're going to see exactly version of Firefox when they were added. Are they enabled by default, or in which version of the Firefox are they enabled by default, along with the preference name. This is how you can find exactly the feature that you're looking for. There's again a lot of features here, and I really like this list, even though it's not completely accurate. I think it's really nice to see exactly which experimental features you can play around with. And lastly, we have Safari. Of course, if you're on Windows, you're not going to be able to test out new Safari features, but Safari has been making a lot of progress, and I really like what they are doing with new web features. They've been first to implement has a number of other fantastic CSS features. So Safari is definitely a browser that has come a long way, and it should not be overlooked. And if you want to enable experimental features in Safari, you'll find experimental features in settings. I will open them with command comma shortcut. And here at the end, you will see feature flags. And this is a really nice and clear list of experimental features that can be enabled or disabled in Safari. This feature flags is available only since Safari 17. In previous versions, you will find this under experimental features tab. But right now in Safari 17, you have this wonderful feature flags section, and there's a number of features that you can include. Everything that is available within Safari will be here, or at least everything that's been newly added to Safari will be here. And you can see exactly the status of each of those features. So some of those are in stable release and they are enabled. Some of those are in testable state and some of those are in preview. Stable status represents features that have been recently shipped in Safari that are enabled by default, and they are still here in this list because this way you can disable them and test for progressive enhancement, or if you're experiencing some kind of problems with a certain feature, you can disable it and see exactly if that feature actually is the problem. Stable features will not be in this list forever. They will be eventually removed, but at least for a while after they have been shipped, you will see them exactly in this list, marked as stable. Next status we have is testable, and those are features that are not enabled by default. They're not really completed, they are in the state of implementation, but they are interesting enough for you to play with them if you want, so you can enable those features. But be warned, features that are in the state of testable are still not completely finished, so you might find a lot of bugs with them, or they might change in a certain way. The last status that you have is preview status, and those are actually features that are closer to being finished, and they are enabled by default in Safari Technology Preview. They're still not ready for stable release, but they will be soon, and they are in ideal state where you can play around with them, where you can find bugs and report those bugs and so on. For example, we have here CSS masonry layout that you can enable and play around with if you want. Features are grouped nicely in different sections, from animation to CSS to DOM, HTML, JavaScript, media, and more. I really like how Safari handles this. I really like that they give you a clear status. This is stable, this is testable, this is in preview. And I think that Chrome and Firefox have a little bit of catching up to do, because right here, if I just go over this list, I can see which features I can play around with, and then I can Google those features, find exactly how to use them, which I don't really have in Firefox or in Chrome, where I have to find features somewhere on the web and then enable them either using the experimental feature flag or directly by enabling feature flag for that particular, well, feature. So this is how you can enable experimental features in Chrome, Safari, and Firefox if you want to play around with those features, and you probably do, otherwise you wouldn't be here. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different experimental feature, or rather, in the next video. But before you go, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. It would really mean a lot, and it would help me understand that you want to see more videos like this one, in which case I will record these kinds of videos. Thanks so much. Bye.